Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? On Sunday evening, the moon will be relatively close to Mars. Now, Mars is not terribly good to look at right now because, as you can see up here, it is only an apparent diameter of 5.8 arc seconds across. So it's really tiny. You might be able to see the polar cap. Not too many markings, probably, but you could try with some additional magnification if you want. It's never a bad idea to keep looking at Mars because then when it finally is at opposition, about every 2 years or so, then you're prepared to see some of the really awesome detail that can be seen then. But what is happening is not only are the moon and Mars together in about the same field of view, and by the way, we're looking towards the west, mostly towards the west, about 3 hours after sunset. You can look anywhere from about 2 to 4 hours after sunset. But you can also see how Uranus is right there too. Boom! It is going to be all in the same binoculars field of view. So if we measure that across, we can just barely squeeze all three of those in to a 7 degrees field of view. That's pretty cool to be able to see something that's our natural satellite, plus Mars, which is the next planet out, plus Uranus, which is way out there in the kind of outer reaches of our solar system. That's a neat view to catch all those together. That doesn't happen very often. What we can also see in a couple days after that, if we go forward, is notice how Mars gets really close to where Uranus is going to be. And if we center this and we zoom in some and then measure that distance, we're talking, we can get both of those in the same telescopic field of view because that is 1 degree across. So if you can get a larger than 1 degree field of view, ideally about a degree and a half, maybe a little bit more if you have a short focal length, excuse me, a short focal ratio telescope with a large long focal length eyepiece, you might be able to capture all of that together, which is kind of a neat thing. And Mars will guide you right there because Uranus is just barely on the edge of naked eye visibility under a really dark sky site, but Mars is pops right out. I mean, you can see that naked eye no problem because it's still sitting at a magnitude of one, so it's as bright as some of the brightest stars out there, and then that's going to guide you right to where Uranus is. That is on the 12th of February, so definitely check that out. And if you go a day or two before, you might still be able to catch it if you got a large enough field of view, but it's enough far, you know, far away from that outer planet that that's going to be a tough one. So see if you can do that on the 12th. That's a pretty cool thing to see. Now let's switch over to the morning sky and see what's going on there. Now this is about an hour or so before the sun comes up. So the sky's still dark, but it's going to be getting lighter. And you'll see that Venus and Jupiter and Saturn are all in a lovely little line right there. They're going to be that way really from let's start with Saturday and just keep going on through a full week. And then look what happens with Venus and Saturn on the 18th. Oh, they are right next to each other. So that's cool. You've got an inner planet that is right next to where an outer planet is. And that's because we're kind of on the edge of where the shadow of the Earth is on the morning side, looking past where the sun is because the horizon is blocking that field of view for us. And then we're looking past the sun. Well, actually, we're seeing, yeah, we actually are looking past the sun because Venus is on the other side of where the sun is, so it's quite rather far away. So if we click on that, you can even see astronomical unit wise, that's it's a full sun distance away basically from us. And then Saturn sitting over there on the opposite side of the solar system is almost 11 astronomical units away. So that's an astronomical unit being the Earth's average Earth sun distance. So that's a long way off. That's a cool thing to see. But I do want to show you one other thing that I think is kind of neat about this. So I'm going to back it up just to maybe the 12th again or so. And you can see how I've got kind of this wide field of view. If you look over here, we've got Vega sitting there. So with the summer triangles in the morning sky, Altair's over here, Deneb's here. So the Cygnus is going this way. So Deneb and then Sadr and then Albireo is right about there. So that's helpful to know. It's going to be pointing kind of towards where Jupiter's at. That's helpful to know because that's about the plane of our galaxy. So it's the galactic plane. I'm going to actually pull that up on some of, I have brought up the wrong thing. On our sky and viewing options window, we can see the galactic equator right here. There it is. See, there's Deneb right there, Sadr, and then where Albireo's at. And then I'm also going to show you where the ecliptic is, and that's the plane of mostly where the planets go, but it's really the line that the sun traces through the sky, but it's about the same as where the planets are going to go at. So if we pop up the ecliptic as well, you can see how our solar system is kind of tipped about 60 degrees or so to the galaxy. So there's Jupiter, there's Venus, there's Saturn that nicely line up there on the ecliptic. And actually, if you look further out, you'll even be able to see where Spica is at in Virgo, which is pretty close to the ecliptic, but it's a star well off, much, much further away. But then our galactic equator, it runs fairly close to where Deneb, Sodor, and Albireo are. So that those three stars will kind of give you that line to see visually, like, oh, hey, we're tipped relative to what the rest of the galaxy is doing, where when it kind of spins around on its axis every 250 million years or so is about how long it takes us to go around there. But we're tipped as we do it, about 60 degrees. And that's a nice visualization of that that you will be able to see in the morning sky. So definitely check out Mars, Uranus, and the Moon on the 10th, and then Mars and Uranus again on the 12th. And then all this week, you can watch as Venus kind of slides towards Saturn. And then on the 18th, it's going to be right next to it. And then we start to lose Venus into the glare of the sun, but you'll still be able to see it for a little while, you know, kind of through the end of February. The Moon actually joins it right there at the beginning of March, and the Moon will be in a well placed actually from the 27th, first, and then second and third. So you can check those out at the beginning of March as well. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.